The office of the dead is a form of the liturgy of the hours, prayed in the Catholic Church, Anglican Church, Lutheran Church, and Eastern Rite churches. The month of November is traditionally a time in which the church prayerfully remembers those who have died. As the liturgical year draws to a close, the church reflects on the end times. We are reminded that our life on earth is transitional. The old world is passing away, and a new creation is being fashioned for us in eternity. Before the new liturgical year starts with the first Sunday of Advent, we look to the saints and to those who have died to show us how to best prepare for the coming of the Lord. As we read in the book For All the Saints, what academic ethicists are rediscovering, of course, is something we have known all along, that we are less influenced by abstract arguments than by the moral examples of other people. Our mothers and fathers, our friends and neighbors, our oppressors and mentors, whether famous, like St. Francis, or known only to us, like a favorite aunt or godparent, saints change us simply by existing. Part of the beauty and importance of saints is that they cannot be constrained by the left-brained logical thought with which the Western world is so enamored. To live in their presence is to open a space in our faith for the creative and unpredictable side of God's dealings with us. More important still is the realization that saints do not exist to support our point of view. In their transparency to Christ, they reveal the truth about ourselves in both familiarity and difference, grace and critique.
Please stand for the lighting of the Christ candle by inquirer Zach Gottfried. Light and peace in Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God.
I saw an immense crowd, without number, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing in front of the throne and of the Lamb. With them we cry out,
praise and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever. Amen.
O gracious light, pure brightness of our everlasting God in heaven. O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, most holy and blessed Trinity. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices. O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds.
The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. With all the saints, we praise you. God of all times and places, continue to recreate and form us with the light of your love. Remembering Christ's incarnation, life, death, and rising, we rejoice to have been born by water and the Spirit at the font, the womb of your church.
All glory be to you, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, in the light of the life-giving love of the Holy Spirit, now and unto ages of ages. Amen.
You, Christ, reign in glory, the eternal chosen one of God. When you came in the flesh to set us free, you took our nature on you, human child of human mother.
To give us life, you died and broke death's power, making us worthy by your boundless goodness. You broke the chains that held us captive and opened wide the gates of eternal life with you.
O Creator God, O Majesty unbounded, your chosen one, worthy of all worship, and the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Complete the work of our salvation. With grace and judgment, come and save your people.
And bring us with your saints to live with you in God's eternal presence.
As we come before the Holy One, we come as we are, wounded or well, sick, sinful, or sorrowful, seeking the grace of Christ, which is sufficient for all our needs.
Let us pray together.
God, concealed in mystery and majesty, we stagger at the mercy that takes our sins as your own habitation. Forgive us when we are unfaithful in word or deed, whether aware or unaware. We have seen your glory and grace in the lives of the faithful men and women who followed Jesus. Reveal yourself anew as we recall their kindness and courage, so that, blessing you for their fidelity to your way, we may be joined with them in faithful service and praise. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The days are coming. It is your God who speaks. When I will establish a new covenant, I will put my laws into your minds and write them on your hearts. I will be your guide, and you will be my people. We are a forgiven people.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. O God, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory be to you, O Trinity, most holy and blessed,
who is now, ever was, and ever shall be, unto endless ages. Amen. Holy darkness, blessed night, heavens and
answer hidden from our sight. As we await you, O God of silence, we embrace your holy night. I have tried you in fires of affliction. I have taught your soul to grieve. In the barren soil of your loneliness, there I will plant my seed. Holy darkness, blessed night, heaven's answer hidden from our sight. As we await you, O God of silence, we embrace your holy night. I have taught you the price of compassion. You have stood before the grave. Though my love can seem like a raging storm, this is the love that saves. Holy darkness, blessed night, heaven's answer hidden from our sight. As we await you, O God of silence, we embrace your holy night. Were you there when I raised up the mountains? Can you guide the morning star? Does the hawk take flight when you give command? Why do you doubt my power? Holy darkness, blessed night, heaven's answer hidden from our sight. As we await you, O God of silence, we embrace your holy night.
I praise Adonai who guides me, even at night my heart teaches me. O God, keep me safe, you are my refuge. I said to Adonai, you are my God, there is nothing good for me apart from you.
The holy people of my land are wonderful. My greatest pleasure is to be with them. But those who rush after other gods will bring many troubles upon themselves. I will not take part in their sacrifices. I won't even speak the names of their gods.
You
Adonai, are all that I have. You are my food and drink. My life is safe in your hands. Within the boundaries you set for me, there are nothing but pleasant places. What a delightful inheritance I have.
I praise Adonai who guides me. Even at night my heart teaches me. I'm always aware of your presence. You are right by my side, and nothing can shake me.
My heart is happy, and my tongue sings for joy. I feel completely safe with you, because you won't abandon me to the grave. You won't let your loved one see decay.
You show me the path to life. Your presence fills me with joy, and by your side I find enduring pleasure.
Glory to you, O Trinity, most holy and blessed.
One God, now and forever. Amen.
I praise Adonai who guides me. Even at night my heart teaches me.
A reading from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. Holy wisdom, holy word.
Thanks be to God."
Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Please stand for the Canticle of Mary.
My soul proclaims your greatness, Lord. My spirit rejoices in you, my Savior. For you have looked with favor on your lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
You, the Almighty, have done great things for me, and holy is your name. You have mercy on those who fear you in every generation.
You have shown the strength of your arm. You have scattered the proud in their conceit. You have cast the mighty from their thrones. You have lifted up the lowly.
You have filled the hungry with good things, and the rich have been sent away empty. You have come to the help of your servant Israel, for you have remembered your promise of mercy, the promise you made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to you, O Trinity, most holy and blessed.
One God, now and forever. Amen.
Now we'll have a reading for meditation and reflection from the book Food for Pilgrims, Chapter 6, Baptismal Spirituality. Baptismal spirituality is centered in the Paschal mystery. The Paschal mystery is more than recalling Christ's death and resurrection as a central part of the Christian story. It carries with it the sense of our becoming incorporated into that story of letting the ministry, death, and resurrection of Christ live through us. As Honoria, a character in the book, and an African princess captured and sold as a slave, said in Madeline Lingle's novel, The Other Side of the Sun,
"We does our dying when we baptize, Miss Olivia. If it ain't done then, ain't never gonna be done properly. When you is baptized, your angel gives you a shove and you touch eternity. Once you brush against eternity, Miss Livy, then time and death don't make no never mind." From page 56. The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Please join me in silent prayer.
Let us join together in the prayer for the order of St. Luke.
O Shepherd of us all, who inspired your servant St. Luke the physician to set forth in the gospel the love and healing power of Jesus, grant, we ask you, your Spirit to the order of St. Luke, that we may proclaim the apostolic hope, magnify the sacraments, and embody Christ's healing grace for all creation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for us. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, the faithful receive the light of Christ. May the darkness be scattered as they are led over the waters of death into eternal light. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
The faithful are nourished at the table of the Savior. May they be welcomed into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all those we have loved who have gone before us, especially those remembered on the altar and with the pitchers in the front of the church, may they be recognized as sheep of the Lord's own flock. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For us who seek comfort and consolation, may our pain be healed and the darkness and doubt that come from grief be dispelled. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
May the petitions written in the prayer intention book be answered. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that God's will for them may be fulfilled, and that they may share with all the saints the eternal kingdom. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer and let our cry come to you for Sister Elizabeth, our abbot, for the officers of the General Chapter, Brother George, Sister Jeanette, and Sister Heather, for our priors, for our brothers and sisters in the order, for a sense of community with others in the order, for the grace to live for you and with each other in faithfully living our rule of life and service. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray that God's saints and angels will show the departed faithful the way to the place that the Lord has prepared.
Saints of God, come to their aid. Hasten to meet them, angels of the Lord.
Receive their souls and present them to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called them home, take them to himself. May angels lead them to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive their souls and present them to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them.
Receive their souls and present them to God the Most High.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Show your loving mercy for all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Mighty God, we offer you praise and thanks for your grace manifested in your saints. Their lives and labors have shone forth as lights in the darkness. In worship and integrity of life, continue our holy communion with them, and by their examples, guide us to be mindful of what is required of us for our time as they have been in theirs. Through Jesus Christ, crucified and risen.
Amen.
In peace we will lie down and sleep.
In the Lord alone we safely rest.
Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping.
That awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
May the divine help remain with us always.
And with those who are absent from us.
into your hands, O Lord. We commend the spirit of our brothers and sisters.
For you have redeemed us, O Lord, O God of truth.
Now the green blade rises from the buried grain. Weed that in the dark earth many days has lain. Love lives again that with the dead has been. Love is come again like weed arising green. In the grave they laid him, love by hatred slain. Thinking that he would never wake again. Laid in the earth like grain that sleeps unseen. Love is come again like wheat arising green. Forth he came at Easter like the risen grain. He that for 3 days in the grave had lain, raised from the dead, my living Lord has seen. Love is come again like wheat arising green. When our hearts are wintry, grieving or in pain, your touch can call us back to life again. Fields of our hearts that dead and bare have been, love is come again like wheat arising green.
The Holy and Blessed Trinity bless you and keep you. The face of God shine on you and be gracious to you. God look on you with kindness and give you peace. Amen.
The Holy and Blessed Trinity bless us and keep us. The face of God shine on us and be gracious to us. God look on us with kindness and give us peace. Amen.
May the souls of the faithful be departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you very much for joining us this evening. We will be doing almost the exact same evening prayer next Monday on November 13th. And so if you know of anybody who would really like to remember their departed loved ones in such a special way, invite them to join you next Monday on the 13th. The fun thing is we're going to be chanting Psalm 23, and we all know that beautiful Psalm 23. Thank you, Brother David, for choosing that psalm. Thank you, Jenny. The music, wasn't that something tonight? That first one was so touching and beautiful.
Thank you for bringing Elk Score. That was so good.
Yeah. Brother David took only a little piece. He wasn't too sure if he liked it, but I saw him sneak back for a second helping, so I guess he liked the elk. So thank you all very much. We're going to be gathering immediately after for companion time for those of you who would like to stay for companion time as we do chapter 6 of Food for Pilgrims on baptismal spirituality. Thank you.